van Golden Ticket presents Queen. En in de red corner, de red nog 1 to beat. Queen is 65.7 kilograms. Representing Dallas Fight Club in Northern Ireland. Piers Armstrong. Fights on the blue corner, making his debut. Queen in the 66 kilograms and representing Shrewsbury MMA.
Here we go, fight number 5 of the evening. We have Piers Armstrong from Devil's Fight Club in Northern Ireland, 0-1, taking on John Tunnicliffe from Shrewsbury MMA, who's making his debut here. Being his debut, he's obviously let a few people know that he's fine, which means I imagine he's taking his training pretty seriously.
Yeah, he's gone in there to look for the takedown, has picked up Armstrong and he's slamming to the mat.
I thought he was going to run him across the cage there like Matt Hughes on Carlos Newton there. Matt Hughes on Frank Trigg.
Yes. So he's working there from guard. Armstrong has closed the guard and is pulling him in to stop him from posturing to throw strikes. He's got to try and break that grip if he can and posture up and try and work through.
Again, I'd like to see Tunnicliffe. Again, there's no need to rush it and get caught. That's the only thing with being your debut. You don't want to get too excited and overcommit.
He's lifted his legs up now. He's got one arm through and he's working for a triangle, but he's been slammed and he's been hammer-fisted a few times. He needs to try and get that foot behind that leg and he needs to pull on that head. Get the head and pull the head down with his hands.
Absolutely.
He's not going to be able to get, unless he goes for an armbar, he's not going to get a triangle choke till he pulls that head down.
And again, this happened to a friend of mine quite recently who he was in a similar position but tried to hammer fist his way out and just got deeper in and eventually got armbarred.
Well, he's got the arm in there and he's slammed a few times.
That was a big slam as well, wasn't it, Ray?
Yeah. Has he let go of the arm yet?
He's still got the arm. No, he's still got the arm.
He needs to get the other... He's a lot closer to the triangle now. He maybe needs to get the arm across the leg across the head and actually go for the armbar. He's kind of...
Here we go, slam number three.
That's it. He's not committing to either at the minute. He needs to get the leg across the head and then go for the armbar because he's not going to get a triangle because he's too postured.
Yeah, we're going to see who's going to burn out first.
He's out of it now. He's to roll through. He's gone straight into side control. So Tunnicliffe has fought his way through that armbar and is now in the strong position.
Again, some good skills being displayed by these guys. You know, Pierce has only had one fight, and Tunnicliffe make his debut. They're displaying some good skills so far.
Yeah, absolutely. He's got to try and Armstrong's got to try and get his guard back now if he can, and maybe even just get one leg in first, the half guard. And he's trying to rise up there. He's been up against the fence, which is good, but he's taken a few shots, which he obviously doesn't want to do.
Yeah, Tunnicliffe does look like the larger, potentially stronger of the two.
Throwing a few knees to the body there as well. That will tire out Armstrong as the fight goes on as well, and soften him up, hopefully help him to look for a submission.
Now, if you're in Pierce's position, what would you be looking to do here?
I would try and get control of the body and try and get a leg in if I can, and try and work back to half guard, which I think he's done.
Yeah, he's got the half guard back.
And he's grabbing the head. He's got to try and break the posture, because as soon as he postures up, he throws strikes.
Tunnicliffe has been busy on the top, though, as well, hasn't he? He hasn't hasn't given him any room to breathe.
No, a good round for Tunnicliffe.
Very good round.
Fought his way through the armbar, but he's pretty much controlled that round. I mean, I would give that round to Tunnicliffe based on control, and he had some good ground and pound. He had a nice takedown, and he did quite a few slams as well.
Yeah, so far, a very good fight so far. Again, the standard of the fight so far this evening has been brilliant.
Yeah, very good. Very, very enjoyable to watch, and this is certainly no different. Interesting to see what the corners are saying now. What's Armstrong's game plan going to be for this round? After, obviously, he doesn't want to be on the bottom again if he can help, but he needs to try and keep the fight standing. Tunnicliffe went in for a takedown quite early on in that, and it was quite obvious that that's what he wanted to do.
Yeah.
And maybe he needs to maybe not back up against the fence, maybe circle away from the fence and make it, not a bit like what Reese did earlier on, and make it hard for him to be put in that position where he can be taken down like that. Yeah. It was quite a big takedown, wasn't it?
I think that definitely makes sense. Both guys even fairly evenly matched, I think. On the ground, though, Tunnicliffe stayed very calm there. Those slams, he didn't put himself deeper into the submission hold.
Yeah, but he was able to work through. He never really looked in too much danger. And once he passed the legs, of course, he was in complete control of the fight there. But Armstrong wants to keep the fight standing. You can see the way he's moving, his footwork, he's punching, he's kicking.
Yeah, he came straight out with a few strikes immediately there. Tanner Cliff again. He's going for the grappling. He's got the clinch.
He's got the defence there. Look, here we go. That is weird. The ref's got to stop that. He's doing it again.
Yeah.
Now he's been taken to his corner. And
a big slam.
Straight into side control as well. Yeah. Straight to full mount now as well. So very strong position for Tunnicliff here.
I'm glad Tunnicliff got to secure that there. Because as you say, you know, the holding onto the cage was a bit naughty there. Yeah. But it didn't seem to get him anywhere now.
He's got a lot of time to work now as well. If he can just keep control, he just throw some punches. There's no way the ref won't stop the fight if he doesn't. If he keeps throwing punches, the ref's going to have to stop the fight because he needs to defend.
Absolutely. Tunnicliff looks like he's come in very good condition, good shape, he's strong.
Armstrong's now got in a good position. He's got his feet against the cage. What he should do is push up against the cage.
There we go.
And try just and push it. Just push him off. He needs to get back to the cage. His best way of getting out of here is getting back up to that cage and climbing up with his feet.
Yeah.
And then pushing him off. That's the only way he's going to get out of that position.
I was going to say striking off the back is the James Toney defence, which essentially didn't go too well for him.
No, that was a big punch there, straight through onto his jaw as well.
I think Tunnicliff.
He is moving, but the ref is coming close to stopping this fight.
Yeah, credit to Armstrong. I've seen many people turtle up and give up in this position, and Armstrong is still fighting it despite being
rained on. Yeah, the ref's had enough now.
At the end of the day, credit to Armstrong, tough lad, but he wasn't going to get out of that position.
No. They've got to look after fighter safety. There's a young lad, they've got a good career ahead of him. Tunnicliff looked very impressive. His ground game's very strong. His takedown.
Yeah, Mark, the rest of the team, and the team.